Welcome to a new episode of my high-performance Java persistence video course. In this episode, we're going to talk about entity association fetching. First, we're going to explain how the FetchType.EAGER and FetchType.LAZY strategies work when using JPA and Hibernate. Afterward, we will see how we can fetch multiple associations, no matter if those are many-to-one, one-to-one, or collections. Next, we will discuss about the N+1 query issue and see what's the best way to prevent it. In the end, we will cover the lazy initialization exception topic and see why we should avoid the open session in view anti-pattern. In the object-oriented domain model, associations are either object references like many-to-one and one-to-one or collections like one-to-many or many-to-many. From a fetching perspective, an association can either be loaded eagerly or lazily. An eager association is bound to its declaring entity, so when the entity is fetched, the association must be fetched prior to returning the result back to the data access layer. The association can be loaded either through table joining or by issuing a secondary select statement. A lazy relationship is fetched only when being accessed for the very first time, so the association is initialized using a secondary select statement. By default, many-to-one and one-to-one associations are fetched eagerly, while the one-to-many and many-to-many relationships are loaded lazily. During entity mapping, it is possible to override the implicit fetching strategies through the fetch association attribute, and combining the implicit fetching strategies with the explicitly declared ones, the default entity graph is formed. These default fetching strategies are a consequence of conforming to the Java persistence specification. Prior to JPA, Hibernate would fetch every association lazily, even many-to-one and one-to-one relationships. Just because the JPA 1.0 specification says that many-to-one and one-to-one must be fetched eagerly, it does not mean that this is the right thing to do, especially in a high-performance data access layer. When executing a direct fetching call or an entity query, Hibernate inspects the default entity graph to know what other entity association must be fetched additionally. JPA 2.1 added support for custom entity graphs, which, according to the specification, can be used to override the default entity graph on a per-query basis. However, lazy fetching is only a hint, and the underlying persistence provider might choose to simply ignore it. Even if JPA 2.1 defines the JavaX persistence fetch graph hint, which theoretically could change a fetch type eager strategy at query execution time so that the association is fetched lazily, in reality, Hibernate ignores it and fetches the eager association anyway. When fetching an entity directly, a left join is used to fetch a fetch type eager association. When the entity is fetched via an entity query, JPQL or Criteria API, without explicitly fetching all the FetchType.EAGER associations using join fetch, Hibernate generates additional SQL queries to initialize those relationships as well. Assuming the post-comment entity has a many-to-one post association that uses the default FetchType.EAGER strategy, when fetching the post-comment entity directly using an entity manager find method call, we can see that a left join is generated in order to fetch the associated post entity eagerly. On the other hand, if we execute the following JPQL query, we can see that two SQL queries are generated. The first one is for the post-comment entity and matches exactly the JPQL query fetching strategy. The second one was executed because the post association uses the fetch type eager strategy, so the post entity association is going to be fetched even if we omit it in the JPQL query. The fetch type eager strategy is not limited to many-to-one and one-to-one associations only. Collections can also be fetched eagerly, but this is usually a very bad idea. Now, if the post entity has two collections, comments, and tags that you want to be fetched eagerly, Hibernate requires you to use a set collection type and not a list type when mapping the child collections. With the comments and tags collections using the fetch type eager strategy, when you fetch the post entity via find method call, you will get the following SQL query. Notice that three left joins are used this time. So, what do you think is wrong with this query? To answer this question, you will have to analyze the tables that are joined. While the post table is associated with both post tag and comments tables, the post tag and comments tables have no relationship. So when using SQL, two tables that have no relationship can only be joined via Cartesian product, which will generate all the possible record combinations between the two tables. So if we have 50 associated post tags records and 100 comments, The Cartesian product will contain 5,000 rows, for each post record matched by the query filtering criteria. On the other hand, when fetching the same post entity using a JPQL query that omits to join fetch the comments and tags collections, we will first get an SQL query that selects the parent post entity, followed by an SQL query that fetches the tags collection, followed by an SQL query that fetches the comments collection. So while these three queries might be more efficient than executing the previous Cartesian product, it's still less efficient than executing just the first query, when that's the only entity that's needed by a given business use case. Therefore, for many-to-one and one-to-one associations, you need to explicitly set the fetch attribute to use the fetch type lazy strategy. If you don't do that, then the default strategy will be fetch type eager, which is bad from a performance perspective. Now, when fetching a post comment entity, we can see that the executed SQL query no longer contains a left join to load the post association eagerly. The post property reference will be set to a proxy object that allows us to load the actual entity data on demand. However, when accessing a property of the post proxy object, we can see that an SQL query is executed to load the associated post entity. So, lazy loading allows us to fetch associations on demand. Now, because the uninitialized lazy association is represented by a proxy, when executing a JPQL query that fetches three post comment entities, we can see that a single SQL query is executed. When the post comment entity is initialized, the post property will be set to a proxy object of the post class type, which has only the identifier set to the value given by the post ID foreign key column. However, if we iterate the comments collection and try to access any non-identifier property on the post proxy, we can see that three additional queries will be executed to initialize all the associated post proxies. This issue is called N+1. Since besides the initial query that fetched n post comment entities, we need n more queries to load all the uninitialized proxies. The larger the value of n, the bigger the performance penalty, since even if each subsequent query is fast, executing n such queries will still add an overhead that otherwise could be avoided completely. Although it is commonly associated with the fetch type lazy associations, the N+1 query problem can also manifest when using the fetch type eager strategy. So, considering that the post comment entity has a post association mapped using the many-to-one annotation, which by default uses the fetch type eager strategy, when executing a JPQL query, if the fetch type eager associations are not explicitly fetched as well, Hibernate is going to initialize every eager association with a secondary select query, therefore causing an N+1 query problem. So, if we run the following JPQL query, which fetches the post comment entities without using join fetch for the post associations, Hibernate is going to execute an SQL query to select the post comment entities according to the JPQL filtering criteria, followed by three additional SQL queries that fetch the fetch type eager post associations because the previous SQL query has loaded three post comment entities. So the N+1 query issue can happen with both fetch type lazy and fetch type eager associations if we don't instruct Hibernate to fetch all the required associations when executing the initial SQL query. To avoid the N+1 query issue, we can use the join fetch clause as illustrated by the following JPQL query. In our case, the join fetch clause instructs Hibernate that the post property of the post comment entity needs to be fetched when executing the underlying SQL query. We can see that the SQL query contains a join clause for the parent post table, and the select clause includes the post table columns in the query results set. Now, when iterating the post comment entities and printing the associated post title, we can see that no additional SQL query is executed, since the post entities have been loaded when fetching the post comment entities. Therefore, the join fetch clause can help us avoid the N+1 query issue by loading multiple entity associations with a single SQL query. The join fetch clause works fine with multiple many-to-one or one-to-one associations, since the result set size is given by the where clause filtering criteria, and it doesn't get multiplied by the joined relations. However, while join fetch works fine with many-to-one or one-to-one associations, fetching multiple collections is more challenging. For instance, considering that we have a post entity that has two list collections, comments and tags. When trying to execute the following JPQL query, which uses join fetch for both the comments and tags lists, Hibernate is going to throw a multiple bag fetch exception. In Hibernate terminology, a bag is a collection that may contain duplicates. In our case, the bidirectional list is treated as a bag, since it doesn't have a built-in mechanism to disallow duplicates as a Java set does. So if we change the post entity so that the comments and tags collections use a Java set instead of list, and rerun the JPQL query that uses join fetch for both the comments and tags collections, we can see that no exception is thrown. However, the result set size is not the expected post entities matching the provided filtering criteria, but a multiplication of the post entity count with the number of comments and tags that are fetched per post. So while no exception is thrown, a Cartesian product was generated, which is no way better from a performance perspective. So to fix this problem, we need to fetch at most one collection per entity query, be it JPQL or Criteria API. This way, we can avoid a Cartesian product in the SQL query. And to fetch other collections, we can use additional queries, like the following one. This strategy works as long as both queries are executed in the scope of the same persistence context, be it a JPA entity manager or a Hibernate session. Since the post entity is already managed, Hibernate is going to replace the tags collection proxy in the currently managed post entities with the actual list of tag entities fetched by the second query. Now, there is a slight problem with this approach. The in clause has a fixed bind parameter limit in Oracle and SQL Server, and it can cause performance problems if the number of bind parameter values is very large. So to address this limitation, we can reuse the first query filtering criteria in the subsequent queries. This strategy does not incur the performance penalties of the in clause, and the execution plan can use the same index or indexes for both queries. As we already saw, for performance reasons, the fetch type eager strategy is to be avoided, since we're better off defining the fetch plan on a per query basis. However, the fetch type lazy strategy is not without issues. For instance, if we don't initialize a lazy proxy association and the associated persistence context gets closed, then when trying to access any non-identifier property of the proxy object, a lazy initialization exception will be thrown, because the proxy can only be loaded as long as its persistence context is open and connected to the database. The best way to deal with the lazy initialization exception is to fetch all the required associations while the persistence context is open. Using the join fetch JPQL directive, a custom entity graph, or the initialize method of the Hibernate utility, the lazy associations that are needed in the service or the view layers must be loaded before closing the associated JPA entity manager or the Hibernate session. Open session in view is an architectural pattern that proposes to hold the persistence context open throughout the whole web request. This way, if the service layer fetched an entity without initializing the associations that are further needed by the UI, then the view layer could silently trigger a proxy initialization on demand. Spring Framework comes with a web filter implementation of the open session in view pattern. The open session in view filter gets a session from the underlying session factory and registers it in a thread local storage where the Hibernate transaction manager can also locate it. The service layer is still responsible for managing the actual database transaction, but the session is no longer closed by the Hibernate transaction manager. At first glance, this might not look like a terrible thing to do, but once you view it from a database perspective, a series of flaws start to become more obvious. The service layer opens and closes a database transaction, but afterward, there is no explicit transaction going on. For this reason, every additional statement issued from the UI rendering phase needs to acquire a database connection from the pool in order to execute a single fetch query in auto-commit mode. More, navigating uninitialized proxies in the UI layer can trigger N+1 query problems, which may affect application performance. And there is no separation of concerns anymore, because SQL statements are generated both by the service layer and by the UI rendering process. So writing integration tests that assert the number of SQL statements being generated requires going through all layers: web, service, and data access layer. Similar to the open session in Vue, Hibernate offers the enable lazy load no transaction configuration property, which allows an uninitialized lazy association to be loaded outside the scope of its original persistence context. Behind the scenes, a temporary session is opened whenever a new proxy association has to be fetched, and just like open session in Vue, a database connection will be needed as well, just for the scope of running the proxy loading query. So like open session in Vue, the enable lazy load no transaction configuration property is also a performance anti-pattern. By properly initializing all the needed lazy associations prior to closing the initial persistence context and switching to DTO projections for read-only views, the lazy initialization exception can be prevented in a much more efficient way. If you like this video, you are going to love my high-performance Java persistence video course. For more details, go to my blog vladmihalcha.com and check out the courses page. If you're struggling with data access performance issues, this video course will teach you how to get the most out of JPA and Hibernate. You have unlimited access to the course material and 14 days money-back guarantee. If you are curious what other people think about the video course lessons, then you should definitely read the testimonials I got from my students. Thank you for watching this video and enjoy running your data access layer at high speeds.